Welcome back to your free training course for Windows 7. In this video, I will look at how to perform remote administration on your Windows 7 computers. There are, of course, lots of graphical admin tools that come with Windows that you can use, but in some cases these tools may not do exactly what you want, or you may need to repeat the same steps over and over again on many different computers. To speed up the process, Microsoft allows you to access Windows 7 using a remote shell. A remote shell is the same as running a command prompt remotely on another computer. Even though the command prompt has been improved since the MS-DOS days, it still is compatible with the MS-DOS prompt and thus suffers from the design limitations of MS-DOS. MS-DOS has been around since the 1980s, so you can imagine computers have changed a lot in that time. To make a more modern command prompt, Microsoft has created Windows PowerShell. Windows PowerShell replaces the command prompt with a more modern command prompt that can access APIs such as .NET and addresses the limitations of batch files created for the command prompt. These commands are called commandlets. If you come from a programming background, you will soon start to see some parallels when using PowerShell. In order to allow remote configuration on a Windows 7 computer, you need to configure the Windows Remote Management Service. This can be done by running the command WinRm QuickConfig. This command makes changes to the Windows Firewall and also changes the service start to delayed start. Delayed start means that when the computer starts up, the start of the service will be delayed, giving time for other services and applications on the computer to start. In order to use remote administration, there needs to be a secure channel between the two computers called a trust relationship. If both computers are in a domain, the trust relationship will already be there for you, so you simply have to run WinRm with QuickConfig as the parameter. If the computers are in a work group, you will need to run the following command on your admin computer. Bear in mind that HTTPS will be used in this scenario rather than HTTP, which means that you will also need to have certificates installed on the network. To demonstrate the remote shell and Windows PowerShell, I will now change to my Windows 7 computer. This will be the computer that I will run the commands on from a remote computer. First, it needs to be configured to allow remote connections. To do this, open a command prompt from the Start menu with administrator rights. From the command prompt, run the command WinRm QuickConfig. The first item I will be prompted for is to allow changing the WinRm service to delayed start. Once I press Y, I will then be asked to make changes to the Windows Firewall to allow HTTP traffic through. Once I press Y again, this computer is now configured to accept remote commands from another computer. I will now switch to my admin computer, which I will use to issue commands to the other computer. Notice I have changed the background to blue to make them easier to tell apart. To start issuing commands, I will launch a command prompt from the Start menu. From the command prompt, I will run the command WinRS. This is the command that will run the remote command on the other computer. After this, I need to put in --, followed by the URL of the computer I am trying to run the command on. The URL also needs to have a colon on the end, followed by the port, which is 5985. Next, I need to add --u, followed by the user account, which is administrator. Finally, I can add the command that I want to run on the remote computer, which in this case is dir of the root of the C drive. Once I enter in the password, a directory will be shown on the remote system. Any command that can be run locally on the command prompt can be run like this on the remote computer. I could, for example, run system information, which will give me some information about the computer. Running commands like this may meet your needs. However, if you want more power and a better system for accessing the internal API inside Windows, you should consider running PowerShell. To run remote commands on another system, you require PowerShell version 2. This comes with Windows 7 by default. If you are running Windows Vista, you will need to install it. To launch a command on a remote system, you need to run the ICM commandlet, otherwise known as the invoke command. The syntax is quite simple. Run ICM, followed by the computer name and the commands you want to run in curly brackets. For example, if I want to find out all the services running on a remote system, I could run the commandlet get services. I will now switch to my Windows 7 admin computer and launch some commands on my Windows 7 computer remotely. First, I will launch PowerShell from the Start menu. The first noticeable difference between PowerShell and the command prompt is that the screen is blue rather than black. Notice the PS at the start of each line. First of all, I will run the command get-wmi object. WMI, or Windows Management Instrumentation, provides access to a lot of information about your system. In this case, I will enter in -class to select a class. In this case, I will select Win32 Desktop. This contains a lot of information about the desktop, such as wallpaper settings, screen resolution, etc. The list is quite long because it contains details for each desktop on the computer. This not only includes the logged-in user, but also any other users on the computer. Since I configured my other computer to accept commands from remote using the WinRm QuickConfig command, I can also run commands on it using PowerShell. To run the previous commands on WS1, I will run ICM at the start of the line, followed by WS1. ICM runs the invoke commandlet, which will run the command on the remote computer. The command I want to run needs to be encased in curly brackets, since it is now a parameter of another command. You can start to see the power of PowerShell. I could write a script to connect to all the computers on my network and perform a check of which wallpaper they had, and thus make sure they are meeting the company's standard. The information shown is quite a lot, so I will reduce it to the bits that are relevant. A lot of commands have additional parameters, and in this case, I can add the property value and enter in wallpaper. This has greatly reduced the amount of information, but there is still too much. To reduce it even further, I will add filter find str/b wallpaper to the end of the command. The filter command or pipe command passes the output from one command to another. The find str command looks for a string on each line out of the output. The /b tells the command to check only from the beginning of the line, and the last part is what string I am looking at. The output now looks a lot cleaner with only the information that I wanted. That's it for remote management. Used correctly in your organization, it can quickly reduce the amount of time you spend performing maintenance on computers. In the next video, I will look at folder virtualization. Thanks for watching this completely free video on Windows 7. For more free videos, study guides, and exam questions, see our webpage. Otherwise, you can always watch all of our videos on our YouTube channel.